Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We only have a few SpaceX updates to begin with, so most of the video will look at Boca Chica infrastructure and Starship updates. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off, just a quick look at the SpaceXFans website, you can see SpaceX look to still be targeting Thursday for the liftoff of GPS-3 SV04. We can hopefully expect a liftoff at 11:24pm UTC or 6:24pm EDT. Somebody tweeted Elon Musk asking if their family could use Starlink in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. He responded and said, yeah, that will be relatively easy as so few users out in the ocean. Elon Musk posted a tweet saying several thousand more Starlink beta participation invitations going out this week. He was then asked when Florida could get Starlink and responded with, lower latitude states need more satellites in position, so probably January. I thought it would be interesting to share this article with some information in the Starlink terms of service. The terms say, for services provided on Mars or in transit to Mars via Starship or other colonization spacecraft, the parties recognize Mars as a free planet and that no Earth-based government has authority or sovereignty over Martian activities. Accordingly, disputes will be settled through self-governing principles established in good faith at the time of Martian settlement. Moving over to Boca Chica, Mary recently did a drive-by of the facility and here's a view of the new bunker structures by the pad. Tankzilla was recently moved to the orbital launch pad but was then prepared to be moved. The roll lifts, which are used for transporting large items down the road, was moved to the launch area for the crane. Then this giant crane was also seen being prepared as they got ready to move it back to the old Gaswell lot. Then yesterday, that's what happened, Tankzilla rolled back down the road to where it started. Also in the drive-by, Mary caught a view of the ground fabrication building, which is where they build stuff like Starship mounts. Anyhow, you can see there are a load of shipping containers now surrounding the building. There's also a restaurant area and you can see the new building that they are currently constructing. Looking at Starship stuff, here you can see a white nose cone which is painted as a lunar lander mock-up nose. There's also a whole load of barrel sections, most of which are likely for Super Heavy. In the last video, we saw a new thrust section that had been sleeved and this was prepared to be flipped. Since then, the section has been correctly oriented and will now be worked on some more before being hooked up to the leg skirt. Talking about legs, we also have some leg mounts that have been spotted sitting on pallets in the yard. There's also the new nose cone that they are currently constructing in the fabrication tent. Also, behind the tents, in place of that thrust section, a new common bulkhead was sleeved and I believe this may be for SN12. We now have SN8, which has continued to undergo preparations for its upcoming series of tests. On the Monday to Tuesday testing window, I believe they performed a short ambient pressure test of this vehicle. Then, last night, SpaceX also appeared to have done a successful nose cone cryo proof test, paving the way for another static fire. The fins on this Starship have also been unfolded as they get closer and closer to the flight in which they'll be utilized. Looking at the road and beach closures in which we can expect them to test SN8, some additional dates have been added. We now also have Thursday 5th and Friday 6th. Austin Bernard asked Musk if SpaceX could livestream the SN8 15km flight. He responded and said, sure, although it might be quite a short livestream. Lot can go wrong, but we'll provide video warts and all. You will see every frame that we do. Looking at the other Starships currently in the works, we also have SN9, which continues to be worked on inside the high bay. This prototype also recently got both of its body flaps attached as it catches up to SN8. They'll definitely want this ready in case anything happens to SN8. A nose cone barrel section with a label of serial number 9 has been spotted sitting out in the yard. There's not too much more to share, but here's the latest SN9 build diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Also in line and catching up is SN10 with this aft section lifted and moved into the mid bay alongside the rest of the tank. The rest of the SN10 tank section was seen being readied for its lift and stack with the thrust section. As of now, they've also stacked these two together and will weld them to form the first part of Starship serial number 10, super exciting. As always, I have to say a huge thanks to the incredible Mary or Boca Chica girl going out there every day to film this awesome footage. Not only that, but a huge thanks to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team doing incredible work behind the scenes. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.